as longly awaited, here's a review and tutorial how to use Qdecoders. So first you connect your Qdecoder to the QProgrammer with a delivered cable. It's actually not very difficult. You can also connect it and then program it with your central if you don't have a Qdecoder, but it's much more cumbersome. Then you connect the QProgrammer to your computer, can be either Linux, macOS or Windows, and then you fire up QRail. QRail is the programming software for the Qdecoders. So here you can turn on and off the power to the decoder you want to program. And then you just read out the Qdecoder, and then it knows exactly what kind of decoder you have connected and what you can do. Then you basically scroll through the long list of presets you have for every country, so, and more have to come depending on the firmware. Then you drag the signals you want to connect to the Qdecoder. In my case, it's this 6-signal SBB main signal, the 5-signal distance signal, and another 5 distance signal. So it comes to exactly 16 outputs. And you can configure the different modes if they have, like the if you want the signal to become black or not. And you just add the address, and all the other signals we get the address on the same decoder. Then you can save the configuration for later use. So afterwards you can check the CVs, and then it's just to send all the configuration to the decoder, which is done by one click. And here it's done. And then you can use test mode to actually test decoders. In case you don't have a QProgrammer, you can also export a CV list, which you can import in Rockwell and programming via your station. Or you will have just to type in manually each variable. So, but if you have one decoder, it might be okay. Otherwise, it might be very cumbersome. Now to the two bad things. Qdecoder don't like welcome and MFX feedback, so they will stop working. How I solved it, I used an old Merklin booster to just power the decoders, so the signal to the decoders. That was very bad. And the second bad thing is, after a while, it just lost configuration. So it was on single one. I don't know why. So I had to go in and reprogram each decoder, which was not very practical. I had to connect the Qdecoder, the QProgrammer to each Qdecoder and reprogram it. But otherwise, I think it's quite the most advanced single decoder you can find, and you can completely pre-program it to do crazy lights if you want to do that. You just have to read the manual. It's quite long and quite big, but you can do a lot of stuff. But even if you want to do simple stuff, it's the simplest way. The Qdecoder is just drag and drop and program.